Very developer heavy, don't worry, it's made its talk a lot friendlier. So my talk is about using child teams. Okay, just a little bit about me. I'm a full stack developer, but not by choice. I'm also the creative director. Basically, I run a small firm, doing some visual communications work. We do a lot of WordPress websites. I like to see myself as a systems integrator, none of the above. I just like to integrate systems. So I've been in web development for 9 years. If you think I look a bit young, it's deceiving. This is my handle. So if you see this snake online, it's probably me. If you see me on WordPress.org and so on, it's me as well. Things I enjoy, so not important, but basically I know what topic I'm talking about. That's what you need to take away from here. So agenda, there's just three things I'm going to cover here. What is a child team? But of course, I'm going to talk a little bit about what's the theme, but that's going to be a 10-second talk. Why use one and how does it work? And then I'm going to teach you how to choose a good parent theme. There may or may not be a demo depending on how my machine works. But without the demo, you should be adequately covered. So it should teach you to use a child theme and how to pick one. So a theme is... has a bunch of things built in, things like functions, templates, styles, and so on. So all these things are actually just files. Yeah, so inside your themes, it's not some magic that appears. And of course, you can consider images as well, but all these are files which can... Sorry, that's not later on. My first time giving a WordPress meetup talk, so yeah. Anyway, the idea of which is that all these can be easily overridden, your changes, if you don't actually put in the child team. Yeah. So more than often than not, and in my own experience, when I started out WordPress, I actually edited the team directly. And then when the team updates, and then I look at it, hey, this update, let's click it, right? And then you think, what have I done? Yeah. And all your changes, especially if you have no backups or no version control, it's all gone. Yeah. So I'm gonna go into a little bit what is child team. The child team is something that overrides your parent team, your main team. So you can add elements to it, and the best thing about it, it doesn't touch your parent team. So when your parent team is updated, and this can be for various reasons, security, improvements, and so on. And if you guys have been using the 20-something team, 16, 15, 14, and below, you see that every few months actually there's an update, whether it's visual updates or it's actually a security update, there are. So more than often than not, yes, hi.
Can you take photos?
Go ahead, please.
I forgot to bring my people.
Don't worry, actually this is going to be on speaker deck. I'm going to give a link later. It's not up yet because, to be honest, I just finished this presentation.
It's also recorded. Yeah. We'll be uploading it to Engineers.SG.
Yes.
Engineers.SG.
So we'll definitely put a link in our meetup group and Facebook, so don't worry. But please take pictures if you want. I spent some time on this. Go ahead. Okay. So why use a child team? So you can update safely, as I was talking about. It's easy to extend. Good parent teams allow you to change things very, very easily. It's fallback safe. So for example, you're writing something, but you haven't written a template for the 404 page, or your archive pages, or your post pages. Your parent team has some templates behind to control this. So if you don't write it in the child team, it's there. So it's fallback safe. Yeah. So I was talking a little bit about making sure that you keep your parent team updated and why you should use the child team. It's mainly because I feel one of the reasons is security. So one of the child teams, sorry, the parent team that I usually use is called Canvas. Then if you notice, there's going to be some security fix once in a while. So if you don't actually use the child team and make sure that your parent team is update safe, then you're going to get into a very vicious cycle where you don't update your team because you're afraid of your changes being erased and you're going to get hacked. Yeah. So I'm with the WordPress .org team and mainly on the support side. So one of the things that we see a lot is actually people not updating their teams because they're scared of changes being overridden. And then they get hacked, and then it comes in a huge vicious cycle trying to clear it up. Then they realize they have to move to a child team, but they have no idea what they have changed in the main team. So how does it work? So WordPress, first thing, it looks for a child team. If you have coded it properly, look for a child thing. Any files that override the parent theme, it will load that first. Then, if there's no file that overrides or they need to load, say you don't have a file for single.php which loads how your blog post looks like, yeah, then they will find the file in the parent theme. So a good parent theme with all these templates will be present, and all you need to do is actually override whatever templates that you want. So another, of course, reason is that parent themes offer you a great range of functions and some level of aesthetic looks that you want. But to really supercharge your site, make it look like a race car, make it look great, you want to use a child theme to do so. So I just want to show you how different it could be. So this is Canvas, and Canvas is by WooThemes. Who here has heard of WooThemes? By the way, I'm not an advocate of WooThemes. I might be listed there, but no relation in that at all. I just like them because I started using them and I use all the products. So Canvas is one of the parent themes, actually pretty much the only one I use it to design for all my clients. So anyway, since I can design it for my clients, go ahead and use it too, it's a good theme. Look at it, it's very simple, clean, but it doesn't look good. Yeah. So one of the sites that we design for my clients is this, so it can look really, really different. Anyway, anyone have been to this restaurant called Green Dot Singaporeans? No?
Yeah.
Yes, good, yeah. So anyway, if you go to the website, if it's messed up, it's not my fault because they did it. But this was the original look, yeah. So this is sort of how it looks like. It can be very, very different. Yeah. So now then, how do we create a child theme? So there are two ways. I'm going to cover one is through code, and it's going to be, don't worry, very, very simple. The initial ways, and the other way is actually just selecting a good child theme. Yeah. So there are three essential files. WordPress.org is going to tell you there are two essential files and one optional one, but to me there are three essential files. One is the style.css. So these are all standard commands you can copy paste from any theme. Yeah, good themes. And at the last part, template, this is actually controls who's your parent theme. So you create this and tell them my parent theme is Canvas, and you actually link it to the parent theme. The second file is the functions.php. I copy paste wrong. I'm so sorry about this. I'm gonna fix this in the latest one. By functions.php, you actually tell it to load both the parent theme style and the child theme style. That's the basic that you can do. And the third one is actually just a screenshot.png file. You can put it in so that I'm going to show you what's going to happen. So this is the parent theme, and this is the child theme. So by just putting these few files in, and you get that, and you can actually, if you hover, you can activate the theme. So of course, changing how it looks and changing the code, that's further up, but it all starts from here. So please don't look at the rest. This is the theme I'm reviewing right now for the .org. So another way of which is that good parent themes actually come with a lot of child themes for you to choose from. Like if you look at the .org theme repository, you see a lot of child themes of 26, 2015, 14, 13 and so on. So these are quite a few child themes that are based on Canvas. As you see, it can look really, really different even with the functionality and the back-end use as well. So a little bit to before you can create a child theme, you might want to identify what is a great parent theme. Because one of the things that I realized from the .org forums is that people don't actually choose a good parent theme, and then by the time they finish doing the child theme, they realize the parent theme is lacking in many ways, possibly the quite strong managed security. So this is a little bit cool, but I don't ever understand if you don't want to. But more importantly, good parent themes have pluggable functions. So this is, it checks if the function exists. So the idea is you could copy this entire function from your parent theme into your child theme, and then change it a little bit. You don't like the markup, you don't like the picture that's displaying, you can delete it and it will work. So make sure that it has pluggable functions. Make sure that your parent theme comes with good comments on the code, so it tells you what you're actually editing. When I started out with WordPress, this was quite essential to me because I didn't know what these theme writers were writing. Generic default styles, so you could go bootstrap, you could go any other ways, but for example, things like this, it helps you control a three column layout, a two column layout, single column. All these codes you will just reuse and reuse without actually writing your own. So generic default styles, and make sure the last important thing is well supported. So take one from a reputable company or a long-term developer who's going to support it for many, many years to come. Because in possibly 5 years later, they're going to discover some security issue, then you've got to upgrade your parent team. And since your child team is based on your parent team, and if your parent team is not updated, your child team is not, it's going to suffer a bit as well. So some good parent teams, 2016, which is going to come out soon in 4.4. But it's already available for you to download. If not, the 2015, 2014, 2013, those are very good parent teams as well. Underscore is a bareback framework for you to create your own team. So you can get it at underscores. If you just search underscores GitHub, you'll get it. Canvas is a paid parent team, but you sort of can just buy it and then use it for a very long time. So this is sort of what I've done. Not that expensive. Genesis framework is also a paid parent team, but it's more of a framework that you can use to design your other teams. Foundation Press is free. You can just Google Foundation Press and then you'll get it, and it's also a parent team that you can use to develop all your child teams. Yeah. So we were mentioning this, right? And then actually in one of our meetups, we were talking, one of our users said, how do I submit a team to say .com or .org team repositories? So I'm going to cover the .org part, and later Jack's going to cover the .com part. Just so that, does anyone not understand the difference between the .org and .com WordPress thing? Yes, hi. Great, okay. So just a quick thing, correct me if I get it wrong. Yeah, .org is based on the WordPress Foundation. It's free, you download the software, you install in your own server or your own hosting, and you run it. You get to install a lot of different things. Basically, anything you download on the net, you can install on it. So WordPress.com takes, and of course, they also contribute to the WordPress.org code. They take the code, they run their service, and you have a select number of themes, am I correct, and plugins that you can use. And you can choose to go commercial. If not, there's a free version that you can use. There are different submission guidelines, because these are two different entities that actually support each other. Yeah. Got it? Good?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm going to cover a little bit about WordPress.org team submission guidelines. So if you have, after this, you have decided that I want to design a small team to submit to the WordPress.org, whether it's to actually boost up your portfolio or just want to give back to the open source community, you can do that. So the process is actually, there's a very, very concise list of guidelines for you to follow. And then you basically just need a WordPress.org account, it's free, and upload the file required for submission. So, if you have uploaded it and you don't really get a reply, you can actually log on to Slack. It's our team chat system, and it's free access to anyone with a WordPress.org account. Go to the team review channel and say, I've got team, but no one's looking into it, and someone will assign someone to review it. Then the team review team review it and then test it with what we call the team unit test. And you can use this link to actually upload your team itself. And once it's been reviewed, you'll be given a list of tips to go through, whether it's things to change or things to improve. And if you completed it, they will list your team under the repository. Yes. So there's quite a few good advantages around this. Of course, you get a little bit of exposure. And if you're running a company, a lot of commercial companies actually do this. They upload the theme there, and then they have another version that's paid for, a professional version. Or they have multiple other themes that they want people to buy. So this is usually what people do. So you give a little bit back, and also, you know, people visit your site and so on. I encourage everyone to try this. It's not always about like it's something free and download, but it's a good exchange between the community and large and WordPress itself. So I'm just going to go through very quick some of the guidelines. Actually, there's quite a long guideline, but it's all very straightforward. Good code, no errors, you've got to sanitize the code. If there's
sanitize the code.
Yes, so, what is your question?
What do you mean sanitize?
So, functions, if you have a text box, make sure you sanitize it, meaning you clean the input, and then when you export, you escape as well. So you make sure that people don't actually put in malicious script into the text boxes that you have created. Yeah. So, and when you actually output it, make sure you escape it. Yeah. So things like that, don't worry, because actually, in the WordPress.org, codex, there's actually a list of things for you to follow, and if you they will tell you sanitize, there's a link, click how do I sanitize. So keep WordPress functions and use them. If there's a WordPress function over the PHP function, use the WordPress function. Do not hard code, and make sure your parent theme or whatever theme you're designing is child theme ready. Naming, do not use WordPress name inside the theme, or do not use the word theme. So if you say your theme is say like my name is John, WordPress John as a theme name, then it's going to look very official when it's not. So that's not encouraged. Make sure it's GPL compatible. That's a license. Everyone here are hopefully with the GPL license. If you are going to put in options for them to change your theme, upload the new image, change the titles and so on, use the WordPress included customizer instead of your own theme option framework. All these are inside here, this link, and you can go and look at it. So this is a little bit of a process of how it looks like. Someone submitted a theme, and then I give a list of items to follow, what you should fix, and so on. And after this is all followed, you can then we'll approve your theme and it will appear on WordPress.org. So actually, I finished this a lot faster than I thought, but. All these slides are going to be on speakerdeck.com. It's not been uploaded yet, but I'm going to fix some of the errors I saw just now. And it's going to be uploaded there. So I'm open for Q&A, if anyone has any questions.
There are a lot of teams that usually they will put their functions in the global scope.
Yes.
And some put all the functions empty inside a class and it will you just make an instance and make an instance global.
Yes.
Are there any pros and cons or advice on this?
Yes. As a PHP programmer and as a general programmer, don't use the global space if you don't have to. But for sure, WordPress uses a lot of global variables. I would say I have not encountered a lot of usages having to use the global space. I mean, keep it to your class space or anything below that. Generally, if we notice, there are very different levels of reviewers, unfortunately, and some of them will actually spot it early on. Then maybe you'll pass to someone who will review your theme again, and they'll probably advise you do not use the global space if you don't have to. Yeah. But depending on how, because WordPress is a large team, and there are varying different of levels of specialties and so on. So. But to answer your questions, don't use the global space if you don't have to. Yeah.
So it means I should probably put my so-called functions inside the class of itself.
If for me as a general way of developing PHP, just use class and namespace and write all your functions inside if you can. Then call instance of your class and run everything. Yeah. I think that's the cleanest way to do things. Not everyone does that, and we don't actually force this on the team submission guidelines, but it's a good practice because in the end, it's easier for you to manage as well. Yeah. I take non-code questions as well, so if you're interested. Yeah. Anyone have any questions? Any team development questions? That's okay too. No?
Can I have a demo about the parent and the child thing?
Yes, I sort of, but honestly, I don't think it truly works right now because I'm not sure whether I'm connected. I don't have a full demo, but I can show you some of the files that were written. Yeah. So if you notice, Canvas is the parent theme. And actually it's all these files that controls exactly how your web page looks like, your website looks like. And then your child theme, which I called Canvas Child. Oh no, where is it?
Mm.
Uh-oh. This, do we have internet here?
Wi-Fi is good.
Okay. I'm gonna connect to the Wi-Fi. Guest. Yeah, okay. For people who want to know, I was hearing some discussion. This is PHP Storm, really good development platform. A lot of people in the WordPress community use it. Yeah. Oh no. I was making sure it was connected.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. I'm just going to open another project.
But it works across, once it's Java, so it's across the cross platform. So it was on good at Mac. And you can jump to function and you can find and stack trace root.
So just now I was showing the parents dot functions.php of the child theme. So this is actually a little bit of this is from CSS. Sorry. Right. Yes. Yeah. So this is a little bit of what we can include here. So this line actually loads the parent theme style, and then this line loads the child theme style, and then it takes a make sure that parent theme is loaded before I load up child theme. So this is actually a full range of other code I use to run the child theme. I don't actually have a fully working demo right now. This computer isn't truly connected. But in the end, if you notice that Canvas itself has a lot more files, and while my child theme is much lesser, I only edited the ones that I wanted. So what I do actually is I copy the file from the parent theme, and then I copy it to the child theme, and then I start editing from there. So in this way, your parent theme always stays with the same code. You can update it while you change whatever you want in the child theme. Yeah. So I'm sorry, I don't have a demo. Yeah. Do I have any questions? No. Okay. Then leave it up to Valentine.
Yeah, we can move on to Jack.
Yes. Do anyone needs a toilet break, like a 5-minute toilet break? Yes, Jack needs a. If you have a 2-minute break, why is it so hot? Yeah.